Are you having trouble building out workflows in Dubsado? Then you need to watch this video. Welcome back to the Productive Co YouTube channel. My name is Ray, and on this channel, I talk about all things Dubsado. If you are trying to learn Dubsado for your business, you should subscribe to this YouTube channel. If you're struggling to build your workflows in Dubsado, you most likely haven't mapped out what your workflows actually are. Every business has workflows, whether you know it or not. When you do a project or a task repetitively, you tend to repeat the same pattern over and over and over, and that ends up being your workflow. In order for Dubsado to take over your tasks, you need to be crystal clear on what tasks you want it to take over, and that's why it's really important to map out your workflows outside of Dubsado before you start building your workflows inside of Dubsado. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to use a free tool to map out your business workflows so that you can successfully build out your Dubsado. In this workflow mapping example, I'm using a free software called Draw.io. That's Draw.io. And what's great about it is that you can save it to Google Drive or you can save it to your hard drive if you would like. It's pretty simple to use. You just select a shape that you want to use on the left side, and you can use the arrow to connect the different shapes. When you want to add text, you just click on the shape and start typing. So you're going to start by thinking about one of the services that you offer and ask yourself what the very first step in that client service provider relationship you have. Generally speaking, it's when the client fills out a contact form. Dubsado calls contact forms lead captures. So in this case, the client fills out the lead capture. Then ask yourself, what's the next thing that happens? I'm going to send my client a welcome email with an info packet and a scheduling link. And then I asked myself again, what's the next thing that's going to happen? And in this case, one of two things can happen. The client can schedule a call or they don't schedule a call. And I've listed out the steps that I'm going to follow for both scenarios. So if they don't schedule a call, I'm going to send a follow-up email. And if they do schedule a call, I'm going to have a discovery call with them. So just keep going through every single step you have for that particular service and ask yourself what can happen and all the different scenarios that can happen. When you look at this as a whole, you'll be able to see what your workflow is for that service you offer. One of the most common mistakes I see is that people think they have just one workflow, when the truth is they require multiple workflows. So if you have two services and anything is different, you need a second workflow for that second service. For example, you might have a second service that follows many of the same steps here, but you might have a slightly different contract or a slightly different proposal for that other service. If that's the case, you actually need to have a second workflow in Dubsado. And one of the ways you can save time is by mapping out your business workflow for one of your services. And then if you realize you need to make a similar workflow for a second service, you can make a copy. So you can just go to File, make a copy, and then swap out a few of the steps with the correct information. That way you're not starting over and building out your workflows from scratch every single time. Once you're crystal clear on what your business workflows are, this will help guide you into what you need to put into Dubsado. For example, this very first step here says the client fills out lead capture. So that means that I need to build a lead capture out in Dubsado. The second step is send welcome email with an info packet and a scheduling link. So I'm going to create a canned email, a welcome packet, and I'm going to make sure that I add my scheduling link in that email as well. So these are the elements that I'm going to start building out in the template section of Dubsado. And then I can tell Dubsado to mimic my business workflows for me. So I'm saving manual labor, I'm saving my time, and Dubsado is going to act like a little virtual assistant and take over many of those tasks for me. This video is part of the Dubsado Blueprint, a free download to help you get Dubsado up and running quickly. I'll link to it down below so you can access it at any time.
If you like this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up so I know to create more content just like this. And if you have any questions, as always, pop them in the comments below and I'll answer them as soon as I can. Thank you so much for stopping by today. Once again, my name is Ray, and I'll see you next time.